Police and other security agencies deployed yesterday in the Chikuvo business hub, following a scuffle among traders who are conflicting over changing their leadership. One faction of the traders wanted to conduct a swearing-in ceremony for new office bearers, which the other faction, in support of the incumbent leadership, protested. Following the death of their former chairperson, Haj Muhammad Katimbo, the traders elected a new committee, but the process was halted by the former Kampala Central RCC, Doreen Keita, saying that the process was unlawful. Today, a section of traders started publicizing the swearing-in of the new committee, which prompted a scuffle with the opposing faction. Police and the army deployed pepper spray to disperse agitated traders and arrested those who had knives and stones. The traders were notified by the current Kampala Central RCC that it is KCCA which is mandated with the process of organizing for the election of the leadership for the traders. The spokesperson of the Chikuvo traders, Sam Muyomba, elaborated on what transpired.
RCC yavao bwebachusa esongeza azimanyi waliwo embeera eyagala okwefaananyiriza bwetyo nga baagala okuteekateeka okulonda okutaabaawo mu bukyamu yesitula ye kennyini omukyala Doreen Keita kati RCC w'e Rubaga n'ayimiriza ensonga ezo.
A day after President William Ruto caved into demands by young protesters to withdraw a deeply unpopular tax hike bill, small groups of demonstrators took to the streets yesterday, calling for the Kenyan leader's removal. Dozens of protesters made their way to Nairobi's Central Business District, with police in anti-riot gear blocking access along roads leading to State House, President William Ruto's office, and Parliament. Isolated scuffles broke out between some stone-throwing demonstrators and officers who fired rubber bullets and tear gas, arresting at least 7 people. After unprecedented scenes broadcast live, saw Parliament ransacked on Tuesday, with police opening fire on protesters, Ruto made a surprise U-turn on the tax hikes and called for dialogue with young Kenyans. Cephas, a 24-year-old student, who only gave his first name, told AFP that Ruto's decision to scrap the tax increase had come too late, adding that it's not about the bill, it's him. We want him out of office. He said many protesters had chosen not to show up on Thursday because they're fearing for their lives.
Do not return. Do not return fire. They have their
fire. Many shops remained shuttered as traders worried about further unrest. Artificial intelligence and the post-5G technology will impact every aspect of human life. Chief executives of technology companies gracing the Mobile World Congress, MWC 2024 in Shanghai, China, have said. During the event, which started on Tuesday and will end on Saturday, top officials from leading telecom companies that are pioneering the 5G technology agreed to combine network technology with AI to increase productivity across sectors such as health, finance, agriculture, education, construction, and industry, among others. Speaking during the event, Chinese tech giant Huawei's president of ICT Products and Solutions, Yang Xiaobin, discussed how AI technology, particularly generative AI, brings new opportunities and requirements to telecom networks. He also noted that generative AI is transforming information production, processing, transfer, and exchange to create mobile AI opportunities and boost traffic, connections, and services. At the event, leading tech firms from across the world are showcasing the next generation of products such as self-driving cars and robots that perform tasks across the construction, security, health, and industrial sectors.
Download the app on App Store or Google Play Store now. Vision Digital Experience, the future of media.